Hi, this is a quick overview of a method how you can stream Cubase with OBS. At the beginning, I also had the situation when Cubase got exclusive rights on the audio device that is built into my PC, and I couldn't use YouTube or record sound from Cubase into OBS. Then I downloaded virtual cable and voice emitter, and in the first part of this video I will show you how I did that. So I'm installing virtual cable and you should run it as administrator. Here you can see that my system uses virtual cable as output device. Then I go to voice emitter page and download it. I use installer and also just install it. Now I need to reboot my PC. Now I will show you my regular setup. Here you can see that I'm using just regular generic OCO driver, and you can see that I have sound but you don't hear it because OBS cannot record sound from Cubase. See, there is sound but you cannot hear it. Now I will run voice emitter and it's starting the service. I should pick some master output audio device, but currently it is used by Cubase, so I'll go back to Cubase and switch it off there and pick voice emitter's audio device. Now I can pick an audio device and it's a table that says the sample rate isn't synchronized, so I will just use different sample rate for my project. And now everything is working. Cubase and also YouTube, they are using voice emitter's audio device, but you still cannot hear because you cannot hear it because I haven't set up the OBS studio. But as you can see here, I will now go to YouTube and just listen to some music. You may wonder why you can hear YouTube but cannot hear Cubase still. That's because of OBS setup. Here I'm showing you my system audio device. It also voice emitter audio device. And the last thing is setup of OBS. So I'm also using their voice emitter audio device, and you can see it in different inputs. Like Cubase is one input and Firefox is another input, but still you can hear both and hear how it is set up. To conclude, I'm not sure that you need to install those virtual cable. I remember that last time I wasn't installing it and I had some difficulties to set up everything properly, so this time on a new machine I have set up it. Okay, as I can see here, a virtual cable is just an easier method to combine few devices into one stream, but Cubase doesn't allow you to use virtual cable as an input-output device, so the only way for Cubase is to use voice emitter. But for other applications you could use virtual cable, so I guess both are useful. For example, if you want to record a sound from YouTube and you don't want to plug your audio interface output to its input, you can use this virtual cable as input in Audacity and just hit record. And in system settings you pick output device as virtual cable, and we cannot hear the sound but Audacity can record it, and as you can see we turn down the voice, the volume, and it's reflected here. So virtual cable can be useful as well. Okay, this is it for this video. Thanks for attention.